Hello student, I am Professor Rohit Salve and in this video I am talking about the MCQs of FYBA compulsory English. So before start the video, I will request to all, please see the video till the end, and if you are new on this channel, so please subscribe the channel and also press the bell icon for upcoming video or new updates. So let's start the video. Engine Trouble by R.K. Narayan. So first question is ... is the writer of the story Engine Trouble. So given options are R.K. Narayan, Rabindranath Tagore, Dilip Chitre and O. Henry. So option A is correct answer here. R.K. Narayan is the writer of the story Engine Trouble. Then next one question is, what was the cost of the ticket for each booth to the visitors? So options are a single anaj, a couple of anaj, three anaj, and last option is five anaj. So option B is the correct answer here. A couple of anaj was the cost of the ticket for each booth to the visitors. Then next one question is, what was the number of the ticket drawn by the narrator? So options are 1004, 1003, 1007 and 1005. So correct answer is 1005 was the number of the ticket drawn by the narrator. Then next one question is, which prize did the narrator win in the show? Options are silver coin, cash prize, road engine, and last one option is gold medal. So road engine option C is correct here. The road engine prize did the narrator win in the show. Then next one question is, which corner of the show was in great favor of the visitors? So given options are lottery, animal show, motorcyclist show, and the last one option is magic show. So option A is the correct option here. Lottery corner of the show was in a great favor of the visitors. Then next one question is, which show came into the city of the narrators? So given options are Disneyland, Gatyland, circus, and the last one option is fashion show. So option B is the correct answer here. Gatyland show came into the city of the narrator. Then next one question is, what was the condition laid by the showman about carrying prize? So options are the showman will deliver the prize at home. Then next one option, the owner will have to carry the prize at his own cost. Then next one option is, the prize will be kept on the ground permanently. Then next one option is, the municipality will deliver the prize at home. So option B is the correct one. The owner will have to carry the prize at his own cost. This is the condition laid by showman about carrying the prize. Then next one question is, how much amount did the owner of Gatyland collect a day? So options are 100 rupees, 300 rupees, 400 rupees, 500 rupees. So option D is the correct answer here. 500 rupees amount did the owner of the Gatyland collect a day. Then the next one question is, where was the show set up? So options are circus ground, municipal ground, and gymkhana ground. So option C is the correct here. Gymkhana ground was the show set up. Then the next one question is, how much amount the showman paid to the driver to bring the engine at the gymkhana ground? Given options are 110 rupees, 105 rupees, 120 rupees, and the last one option 100 rupees. So here option B is the correct. 105 rupees amount the showman paid to the driver to bring the engine at the Gymkhana ground. Then next one question is, what town is the novel set in? Given options are Malgudi, Mysuri, Mumbai. So option A is the correct here. Malgudi town is the novel set in. Next one question is, how is R.K. Narayan described? Given options are Indian novelist, and option B is chief of British novels intelligence for the Mediterranean 1913 to 1990. So option A is the correct answer here. Indian novelist R.K. Narayan as a described. Then next one question is, in R.K. Narayan's name, what do the initials of R.K. stand for? So given options are Rashipuram Krishna. Then next option is Rashipuram Krishna Swami. So answer B is the correct answer here. Rashipuram Krishna Swami. Then next one question is, lots of Narayan stories are set in this fictional town. Name it. The given options are Raipur, and last one option is Malgudi. So last one option is correct, Malgudi. Lots of Narayan stories are set in this fictional town. Name it, Malgudi. Then next one question, what are the main themes of the Narayan's fictions? So given options are, option number first is everyday village lives in India and simple peoples with the simple lives living in the changing world. And the next one option is no themes. So option first, option A is the correct one here. Every village lives in India and simple peoples with the simple lives living in the changing world. This is the main themes of the R.K. Narayan's fictions. Then next one question is, what is the nationality of R.K. Narayan? So given options are Switzerland, and next one option is Indian. So second option is correct, Indian, the nationality of R.K. Narayan. Then the next question is, Narayan's first novel that was published in 1935. Given options are The Vendors of Sweets, and the last one option is Swami and Friend. So option B is the correct here. Swami and Friend is the first novel that was published in 1935 by R.K. Narayan. Then next one question is, upon what autobiographical event is Narayan's The English Teacher based? Given options are Narayan's year as an English teacher in the 1930s and 1940s. Next one option is the death of Narayan's wife. So option number second, option B is the correct answer here. The death of Narayan's wife. These autobiographical events is Narayan's The English Teacher's base. After the engine trouble prose, we will going toward the next prose writing, On Saying Please by A.G. Gardner, Alfred George Gardiners. So first one question is, what is the real courage according to the A.G. Gardiners? Given options are course of actions, boldness, confidence, and leadership. So option A is the correct answer here. Course of action is the real courage according to the A.G. Gardiner. Then next one question is, what essay on fear written by A.G. Gardiner focuses on the theme of? Given options are conflicts, second one option is fear, then next one tension, and the last one option is disappointment. So option B is the correct answer here. Fear, the essay on fear written by A.G. Gardiner focuses on the theme of fear. Then next one question is, who threw the strangers out of the lift in this essay on saying please? Given options are stranger, liftsman, old man, watchman. So option B is the correct answer here. Liftman threw the stranger out of the lift in the essay on saying please. Then the next question is, the essay on saying please is written by. Given options are Francis Bacon, H.G. Wells, A.G. Gardiner, and the last one option is Charles Lamb. So option C is the correct, A.G. Gardiner. The essay on saying please is written by A.G. Gardiner. Then next one question is, the essay on saying please reveals the. Given options are reality of life, artificial behavior, bad behavior, and the last one option is good manners. Correct option is option A, reality of life. The essay on saying please reveals the reality of life. Then the next one question is, on saying please is the pain work of. Given options are Emily Dickinson, Alfred George Gardiner, Herbert Gold, none of the above. So option B is the correct answer here. Alfred George Gardiner written a pain work of on saying please. Then the next question is, Alfred George Gardiner was an. Given options are English journalist, biographer, essayist, all of the above. So option D is the correct option here. All of the above. That means Alfred George Gardiner was an English journalist also, biographer also, and essayist also. So option D is the correct here. All of the above. Then next one question is, he is the world famous personality in. He means A.G. Gardiner is world famous personality in. Given options are language, literature, science, and psychology. So option B is the correct answer here. A.G. Gardiner is the world famous personality in literature. Option B is the correct answer here. Then the next question is, dash 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 is the pen name of the Alfred George Gardiner. So given options are Alfred, George, Sir Gardiner, and the last option is Alpha of the Plough. So option last option is correct. Option D is the correct. Alph of the Plough is the pen name of Alfred George Gardiner. Then the next question is, Alfred George Gardiner was born on. Given options are 1st June 1865, 2nd June 1865, 2nd June 1856, 1st July 1856. So given options, option B is the correct here. 2nd June 1865 was born of birth date of the Alfred George Gardiner. Then next one question is, he was the dash 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 of the National Anti-Sweating Leagues. He means A.G. Gardiner. And given options are worker, supporter, chairman, and seat members. So option C is the correct answer here. Chairman. A.G. Gardiner was the chairman of the National Anti-Sweating Leagues. Then next one question is, National Anti-Sweating League was an. Given options are anti-sweating group, advocacy group, next one option is anti-crime group, and the last one option is literature group. So option B is the correct answer here. The National Anti-Sweating Leagues was an advocacy group. Then the next one question is, he was born in. गिवन ऑप्शंस आर चेम्सफोर्ड, न्यूयॉर्क, कैलिफोर्निया, लंदन. सो ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर हियर, चेम्सफोर्ड. एजी गार्डिनर वॉज बॉर्न इन चेम्सफोर्ड. देन द नेक्स्ट वन क्वेश्चन इज ही डाइड ऑन, गिवन ऑप्शंस आर 2 June 1946, 2 March 1946, 2 July 1964 एंड 5 June 1945. सो ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर हियर, ए जी गार्डिनर डाइड ऑन 2 March 1946. देन द नेक्स्ट वन क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम 1915 ही कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू, ही मीन्स ए जी गार्डिनर. गिवन ऑप्शंस आर द इनक्रेडिबल्स, द सुपर हीरोज, द स्टार्स एंड द लास्ट वन ऑप्शन इज एनोनिमस. सो ऑप्शन करेक्ट आंसर इज द स्टार. फ्रॉम 1950 ए जी गार्डिनर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू द स्टार. देन द नेक्स्ट वन क्वेश्चन इज डैश 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 आर द वैल्यूएबल्स इन लाइफ. गिवन ऑप्शंस आर फ्रेंड्स, फोर्स, गुड मैनर्स एंड द लास्ट वन ऑप्शन इज फैमिली मेंबर्स. सो ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर हियर, गुड मैनर्स आर वैल्यूएबल इन लाइफ. देन द नेक्स्ट वन क्वेश्चन इज डैश डैश आर नॉट लीगल ऑफेंस. गिवन ऑप्शंस आर ऑप्शन ए इज गन शूटिंग, ऑप्शन बी हैंड गेम, ऑप्शन सी रेसलिंग, ऑप्शन डी बैड मैनर्स. सो ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर हियर, बैड मैनर्स आर नॉट अ लीगल ऑफेंस. देन द नेक्स्ट वन क्वेश्चन इज स्मॉल वर्ड ऑफ डैश डैश मेक द व्हील ऑफ लाइफ ग्रेसी. सो गिवन ऑप्शंस आर ऑप्शन ए इज कर्टसी, ऑप्शन बी इज एंगर, ऑप्शन सी बटरिंग, ऑप्शन डी ऑयलीनेस. सो ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर हियर, कर्टसी. स्मॉल वर्ड्स ऑफ कर्टसी मेक द व्हील ऑफ लाइफ ग्रेसी. देन द नेक्स्ट वन क्वेश्चन इज डैश 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 मेक द लाइफ रिपल्सिव एंड डिफिकल्ट टू लिव ऑन. गिवन ऑप्शंस आर एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनेंस, सेकंड ऑप्शन इज बैड मैनर्स, रिलेशंस एंड क्वारल्स. सो ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर हियर, बैड मैनर्स मेक द लाइफ रिपल्सिव एंड डिफिकल्ट टू लिव ऑन. देन द नेक्स्ट वन क्वेश्चन इज लॉ डज नॉट परमिट अस टू डैश डैश इफ वी आर द विक्टिम्स ऑफ द बैड मैनर्स. सो गिवन ऑप्शंस आर केस बैक, हिट बैक, टेक रिवेंज, नन ऑफ द अबव. सो ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर हियर, हिट बैक. लॉ डज नॉट परमिट अस टू हिट बैक इफ वी आर द विक्टिम्स ऑफ द बैड मैनर्स. देन द नेक्स्ट वन क्वेश्चन इज डैश 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 क्रिएट अ चेन ऑफ द रिएक्शंस. गिवन ऑप्शंस आर बैड मैनर्स, गुड मैनर्स, बोथ ए एंड बी मीन्स बैड मैनर्स एंड गुड मैनर्स ऑल्सो एंड द लास्ट वन ऑप्शन इज क्रूएलनेस. सो ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर हियर, बैड मैनर्स एंड गुड मैनर्स बोथ मैनर्स क्रिएट द चेन ऑफ रिएक्शन. देन द नेक्स्ट वन क्वेश्चन इज लिफ्ट मैन threw the man's out of the lift because he didn't say. Given options are top, top sir, top please and please. So option C is the correct answer here. Lift man threw the man out of the lift because he didn't say top please. Then the next one question is the man's life would become difficult to live because of. Given options are saying please, mad manners, courtesy, discourtesy. So option D is the correct answer here. The man's life would become difficult to live because discourtesy. Then the next one question is if one is assaulted dash dash one can realities accordingly. Given options are emotionally, mentally, physically and hurtly. So option C is the correct option here, physically. If one is assaulted physically, one can retails accordingly. Then the next one question is ... are not put in the category of legal offense. So given options are murder, physical violations, bad manners, good manners. So option C is the correct answer here, bad manners. Bad manners are not put in the category of the legal offense. Then the next one question is, once the writers had the chance to travel in ... So given options are car, aeroplane, ship or bus. So given options, option D is the correct answer here, bus. Once the writer had a chance to travel in a bus. Then the next question is, he was with ... money in his pocket. Given options are enough, a lots of, 0, 1 pound. Option C is the correct option here, 0. He was the 0 with money in his pocket. Then next one question is ... was the person the peoples waited for his bus. So given options are discourtesy, cheap ticket, courtesy and manners. So option C is the correct answer here, courtesy. Courtesy was the persons the peoples waited for his bus. Then next question is, the author sitting on the top of the bus was. Given options are looking sky, reading book, reading newspaper, reading story. So option B is the correct answer here. The author sitting on the top of the bus was the reading the book. Then the next question. In this essay, writer explained the importance of. Given options are courtesy, success, talking goods and saying please. So option D is the correct answer here, saying please. In this essay, writer explained the importance of saying please. Then the next one question is, the sensitive part of the writer's the toe was trampled by. Given options are policeman, conductor, wood and foe. Then the option B is the correct answer here, conductor. The sensitive part of the writer's toe was trampled by conductor. Then the next one question is, the author was hurt badly but ... healed his pain. Given options are bandage, steams, good behavior and the last one option is painkiller. So option C is the correct answer here, the good behavior. The author was hurt badly but good behavior healed his pain. Then the next question, if any burglar breaks into house, one is allowed to. Given options are host him, kill him, welcome him and last one option is hit him. So last one option, option D is the correct answer here, hit him. If any burglar breaks into house, one is allowed to hit him. Then the next one question is ... silent if anyone injures the feeling of anyone. Given options are police, judge, law, family. So option C is the correct answer here, law. Law is the silent if anyone injures the feelings of anyone's. Then the next one question is, the liftman retaliates bad manners with. Given options are good manners, courtesy, bad manners, politeness. So option C is the correct answer here, bad manners. The liftman retaliates bad manners with the bad manners. Then the next one question is, the bus conductor
has made his life easy by showing dash dash. So given options are wealth, strength, good manners, empty hands. So option C is the correct option here, good manners. The bus conductor has made his life easy by showing good manners. After on saying please essay, prose writing, we will going toward the next prose writing, The Gift of the Magi by O. Henry. So, first question, when Jim and Della realize the full extent of what they have done, they given options are refuse to believe it, try to make the best of it, look for someone else to blame. Next option, make plans to undo what they have done. So option B is the correct answer here, try to make the best of it. When Jim and Della realize the full extent of what they have done. Then the next question is, O. Henry referenced the Magi in both the titles and the story itself. What kind of the literary devices is this? Given options are foreshadowings, allusion, metaphor, personifications. And correct option is option B, allusion. Then the next one question is, at the end of the story, Jim put his gift from Della away from safekeeping because given options are, it is a frail, it is a valuables in terms of the money, it is a valuable in the emotional terms, and the last option, she doesn't have a current use for it. So last option, option D is the correct here. She doesn't have a current use for it. At the end of the story, Jim puts his gift from Della's away from safekeeping because she doesn't have a current use for it. Then the next question is, Della's hair and Jim's watch have always made them feel. Given options are proud, nervous, worthy of each other's, ashamed of their other's possessions. So option first, option A is the correct answer here. Della's hair and Jim's watch have always made them feel proud. Then the next one question is, at the beginning of the story, which of the following is most upsetting to the Della? So given options are the thought of the parting with her hair, the thought that short hair may be unattractive. Next option, the idea of not having the present good enough for Jim. And the last one option is the possibility that Jim's would not be able to buy her gift. So option C is the correct answer here. The idea of not having a present good enough for Jim. Then the next question is, why does Jim react so strangely when Della tells him she has sold her hair? Given options are, he thinks she looks like a chorus girl. Then next option, he is upset that she didn't consult him. Then next option, he is ashamed of not being an adequate provider. And the last option is, he has bought a gift for her that is no longer usable. So option D, last option is correct here. He has bought a gift for hers that is not longer usable. And that is the reason Jim reacts so strangely when Della tells him she has sold her hair. Then the next question is, Della chooses the gift she gets for Jim because it. The given options are cost just the right amount. Next option is seem to be made for him. Then will make his old watch look like now. And the last option is surely nicer than what he has bought her. So option B is the correct option here, seem to be made for him. Della choose the gift she gets for James because seem to be the made for him. Then the next question, when Della opens her gift, she is overcome with mixed feeling that includes all of the following except. Options are guilt, despair, delight, disbelief. So option A is the correct here, guilt. Then the next question, what type of the irony used in the story? The options are situational irony, dramatic irony, verbal irony. So in this story, the gift of the Magi, O. Henry uses the situational irony. So option A is the correct here. Then the next question, Jim has told what in order to buy a present for Della? Options are his family's watch, he didn't sell anything, his shoes, his overcoat. So option A is the correct here, his family watch. Jim has sold what in order to buy present for Della. Then the next question is, Jim reacts strangely to the news of Della's hair being sold because. Options are, he thinks she looks like a Coney Island chorus girl. Then option B, he thinks she looks like the truant schoolboy. Then option C, he is upset that she did not consult him about her hair first. Then option D, he knows that he has bought something she cannot use. And the last option is, he is ashamed that he could not provide better for his family. So option D is the correct here. He knows that he has bought something she cannot use. Then the next question is, at the end of the story, Jim put his present from Della's away because. Options are, he has no use for it at the moment. Next option, it is too valuable to use on the daily basis. Then it is gaudy and sticks out like the sore thumbs. And the next option is, it is the fragile. And the last option, none of the above. So option A is the correct here, he has no use for it at the moment. And that is the reason at the end of the story, Jim puts his present from the Della away. He has no use for it at the moment. Then the next question, the story uses the literary devices known as dash dash or a situational twist in a plot that the reader may not guesses or expect. So options are dialogue, metaphor, irony and exposition. So option C is the correct answer here, irony. The story uses the literary devices known as irony or the situational twist in the pilot that the reader may not guesses or expect. So irony is the correct answer here. Then the next question, plot is the dash dash of dash dash in a story Gift of the Magi, each leading to or the causing the next to the occur. So answer is a sequence or event. Given options are actions, heroes, absence, actions, cast and the character, and last one option is sequence and event. So option D is the correct answer here, sequence and event. So plot is the sequence of the events in a story, each leading to or the causing in the next to occur. Then the next question is, when was the Gift of the Magi first published? The options are 1865, 1905, 1953, 1765. So option B is the correct answer here, 1905, the Gift of the Magi published. Then the next question is, how much money has Della saved up in the opening the gift of the Magi. The given options are $1.96, $5.24, $1.87 and $4.23. So option C is the correct answer here, $1.87. Money has Della save up in the opening of the gift of the Magi story. Then the next question is, how long is it until the Christmas in the opening of the gift of the Magi? So given options are 1 week, 1 day, 2 days and 3 days. So correct answer is option B, 1 day. 1 day it until Christmas in the opening of the gift of the Magi. Then the next question is, what does Della do after counting her money in the beginning of the story, The Gift of the Magi? Given options are, she calls for the cab, she weeps, she calls her mother, she cheers. So option B is the correct option here, she weeps. When Della counting her money in the beginning, The Gift of the Magi story. Then the next questions, how much is the cost of the room where Della and Jim live? Given options are $50 per week, $5 per week, $8 per week and $20 per week. So option C is the correct option here, $8 per week is the cost of the room where Della and Jim live. Then the next question is, how is the letterbox described as Della's and Jim apartment buildings? Then given options are, unable to open due to the broken door, rusted completely shut, permanently locked, and the last one option is too small to hold a letter. So option C is the correct answer here, permanently locked. Then the next question is, how is the electric bill at the Jim and Della apartment described? Given options are, it is tinkly assault. And second option is, it does not work. Then next one option is, it is incredibly loud. And the last option is, it buzzes non-stop. So option C is the correct answer here, it is incredibly loud. Then the next one question is, why does Della go to the Madden Sovereign shop? Given options are, Della wants to borrow money from Madden Sovereign. Next one option is, she is buying a gift for her husband at the Madden shops. Then the next one option is, Della works at the shops with the Madden Sovereign. And the last one option is, she is selling her hair to the Madden Sovereign. So option D, the last option, is the correct option. She is selling her hair to the Madden Sovereign. That is the reason Della go to the Madden Sovereign shop. Then the next one question is, what does Della do with the money from the Madden Sovereign? So given options are, Della uses the money to buy food at the market. Then next option, she uses it to buy a new watch for Jim. Then next option, Della uses the money to buy watch chain for Jim. And the last option is, she gets haircut to look nice for the Christmas. So option C is the correct answer here, Della uses the money to buy a watch chain for the Jim. Then the next one question is, what does Jim give to the Della as the Christmas present? Given options are, a set of beautiful combs for her hair. Then next option, a watch like the one he has. Then the next option, a wig to cover her short hair. And the last option is, a silver chain to wear around her neck. So option A is the correct answer here, a set of beautiful combs for her hair. This gift give to the Della on the Christmas present from Jim. Then the next question is, what does Della buy for Jim? Given options are, a chain for his pocket watch. Then the next option, a better wedding ring. Next option, a
Mulkey's wallet, and the last option is find cigar. Okay, so the first option A is the correct answer here, a chain for his pocket watch. This Della buy for the gym. How much did Della have initially to spend on Jim's gift? So options are $20, $60, $21.87 and $1.87. So option D is the correct answer here, $1.87. Then next question is, what does Della worry about regarding her husband? Given options are that he will no longer find her attractive, option B that he won't like her gift, option C that he did not purchase a gift for her, and option D is that he will be angry at her for spending too much. So option A is the correct answer here, that he will no longer find her attractive. Then the next one question is, Della's hair reaches her ... Given options are option A shoulder, option B waist, option C knees, and option D calves. So option C is the correct answer here, knees. Della's hair reaches her knees. Then the next question is, in the attempts to minimize her haircut, Della uses a curling irons. O. Henry uses a smiles to describe the finished product. Within 40 minutes, her head was covered with the tiny clothes-lying curls that made her looks wonderfully like. Given options are child's dog. Then next option is scared porcupines. Then the next option is prawn schoolboy. And the last option is comical puppets. So option C is the correct answer here, Tront schoolboy. Then the last question, the theme of the story is that Jim and Della loves for each other's is much more valuable than ... So given options are material gifts, then next option is expensive dinner, then next option is person's opinion, and the last option is verbal expressions of the love. So option A is the correct answer here, material gift. The theme of the story is the Jim and Della love for each other is the much more valuable than the material gift. Then after the prose section, we will going toward the poetic section, and the first poetry is A Red Red Rose by Robert Burns. So first question is, oh my love is like the red red rose, represent which type of figurative language device? And given options are symbolism, hyperbole, metaphor, and the last one option is simile. So last one option, option D is the correct answer here, simile, figure of speech used in the poem Oh My Love is Like a Red Red Rose. Then the next one question is, in the poem Burns refers to his love interest as which of the following? Select all that apply. Given options are his bonnie lass, my only rock, this bonnie lad, and the last one is my only love. So last one option is correct here, option D is the correct, my only love. Then the next question is, Robert Burns, the author of Red Red Rose, is also known for penning the name. Given options are Old Grey Goose, then Ode to the Red Rose, Auld Lang Syne, and the last option is Old Rays of Yore. So option C is the correct answer here, Auld Lang Syne. Is the Robert Burns, the author Red Red Rose, is also known for painting the poems Auld Lang Syne. Then the next one question is, Red Red Rose is written in, the given options are Sanskrit, Scot, Southern, and Swahili. So option B is the correct answer here, the poem Red Red Rose is written in Scottish dialect, means Scot. Then the next one question is, and I will come again, my love, though it were 1,000 miles. The above line from the poem use which types of the figurative language? And given options are hyperbole,
symbolism, alliterations and metaphor. So option A is the correct here, hyperbole. Then the next one question is, what is the total length of the Robert Burns piece of the Endless Love, A Red, Red Rose? Given options are 26 stanzas, 56 stanzas, 60 line and 116 line. So option C is the correct answer here, 16 line. So then next question is, in A Red, Red Rose, Robert Burns realizes on what the time scales to provide the extent of his love with the some scope. Then given options are cosmic, geolics, mythics and historicals. So option B is the correct option here, geolic. Then the next one question is, what provide the inspirations for A Red, Red Rose? Then given options are folk song, an epic poem, a Shakespearean sonnet and the Canterbury Tales. So option A is the correct answer here, A Red, Red Rose poem is a folk song. Then the next one question is, what is the rhyme scheme in the first two verse of this poem, Red, Red Rose? Given options are, first option is ABCB, then second option is AA BB, and option third one is ACBA. So option A is the correct answer here, ABCB. This is the rhyming scheme in the first two verses of this poem. Then the next one question is, the rhythm rhyme scheme alters abruptly in the verses 3 and 4 of these poems. What is the effect of these changes? Given options are, it draws our attention to how unhappy the speaker is about his situation. Then next option, it diminishes the significance of the message being given to us by the poet. And the last one option is, it brings the poems to the empathetic climax. So option C is the correct answer here, last option is correct here. Then the next question, what overall impressions of the speaker are we left with the end of the first verse? So given options are, the speaker is not overwhelmed by his emotion. Next option, the speaker is being far from a serious. And the last option is, the speaker is being earnest in his declarations of the love. So option C is the correct option, last one option is the correct. Then the next question is, what is the established in the final verse of the poem? A humorous tone, an argumentative tone, and the last one is a tone of the despondency. So last one option is the correct, tone of the despondency. Then next question, which of the following are main themes of the poem? Given options are everlasting or unenduring love and the power of the human emotion. Then next option is hypocrisy and the social justice, and the last option is the passage of times and the unpredictability of the love. So option first is the correct, option A is the correct, everlasting and the enduring loves of the powers of the human emotion, which is the themes, main themes of this poem. And the next one question is, roses like many other objects are often given a symbolic meaning. Specifically, which of these most likely to be the attributed to the red roses? And given options are purity, passion, calmness, luck. So option B is the correct option here, passion. Roses like many other objects are often given symbolic meaning, specifically passion. Then the next one question is, Red Rose is the song featured in the Alpha Wales 1986 album, which lumps originally coined by the Sir Thomas More to portray an ideal society. Complete the name of the album in which the single was featured, Afternoon In. Given options are Wonderland, the Pacific Ocean, then the Land Down Under, and the last one option is Utopia. So option D, last one option, is the correct here. Then the next one question is, A Red, Red Rose is possibly one of the most famous poems related to these flowers. Which Scottish poet, also known for the works such as The Man's of Man's That and The Odious Lang Syne, is the author of this romantic poem? And
The given options are William Blake, Walter Scott, Mark Twain and Robert Burn. So option D is the correct option here, Robert Burn. Then the next one question is, the most counties in the United Kingdom have the nicknames with the interesting backgrounds. Which of these counties birthplace of the comedians like the George Formby and the Ken Dobbs is the nicknames the Red Red Rose Country. Given options are Kent, Middlesex, then Lancashires and the Yorkshire. So option C is the correct answer here, Lancashire. Then next question is, even though its color is not exactly mentions, one of the most famous Rhodes quote says that a rose by any other names would smell so sweet. In which legendary Shakespeare plays about the star-across lovers can then quotes be found? And the given options are As You Like It. Then next one option is Hamlet. Last next one option is Romeo and Juliet. And the last one option is Macbeth. So option C, Romeo and Juliet option, is the correct. Then next one question is, what does the first stanza suggest about the speaker's love? And given options are, the speaker's love is strongest in summer, the speaker's love is dangerous like the thorny roads, then the speaker's love makes him want to play music, and the last one option is, the speaker's love is beautiful. So option C, third option, is the correct here. The speaker's love make him want to play music. Then the next question is, and fear the whales, my only love, and fear the whales, and I will come again, my love, though it were 10,000 miles. What does the speaker mean by this final stanza? And given options are, the speaker is going on the journey and will never return. Then the next option, the speaker is going away but will return to matters what. Then the next option is, this person, the speaker loves, is going on a trip. And the last option is, even though the speaker lives in the another parts of the world, his love will never die. And option D is the correct answer here. Even though the speaker lives in the another parts of the world, his love will never die. Then the after MCQs of the poem Red Red Rose, we will going towards the next MCQs of the poem Leave This Chanting and Singing by Rabindranath Tagore. So first question is, Rabindranath Tagore wrote, given options are poems and plays, novels and short stories, and the last one option is all the above. So option C is the correct answer here, all the above, means Rabindranath Tagore wrote poems and plays, novels and short stories also. Then the next question is, Rabindranath Tagore was Indian to win the Nobel Prize. So options are first, second and third. So first option is correct, option A is the correct. First, Rabindranath Tagore was the first Indian to win the Nobel Prize. Then the next one question is, the name of Rabindranath Tagore's Nobel Prize winning book. So given options are The Untouchable, Gitanjali and The Discovery of the India. So option B is the correct answer here, Gitanjali. Gitanjali is the name of the Rabindranath Tagore's Nobel Prize winning book. Then the next one option, then the next one question is, which year did Rabindranath Tagore win the Nobel Prize? Given options are 1913, 1923 and 1933. So option A is the correct answer here, 1913 years Rabindranath Tagore got the Nobel Prize. Then the next one question is, which of the following poems has been composed by Rabindranath Tagore, his family, to every Indian? Given options are Vande Mataram, Jana Gana Mana, Sare Jahan Se Acha. So option B is the correct answer here, Jana Gana Mana. Then next one question is, which of the neighboring countries also has a song of the Tagore as their national anthem? And given options are Sri Lanka, Myanmar and the Bangladesh. So option C is the correct answer here, Bangladesh.
Then the next one question is, what is the name of the university founded by Rabindranath Tagore? And given options are Shantiniketan, Vishwabharati and Kalkikshetra. The option A is the correct answer here, Shantiniketan. Then the next one question is, in this poem the poet addressing you, given options are the reader, the writer, the worshippers, the worker. And in this poem, poet addresses to the worshipper. So option C is the correct answer here, the worshipper. After that, the next question, the poet's sound in these poems, given options are angry, irritated, impatient and horrible. So option C is the correct answer here, impatient. Then the next question, the poet is given options are ordering, admonishing and advising to the worker. So option B is the correct answer here, admonishing. Then the next one question is, the poet asking the worshippers, given options are 2 questions, 3 questions, 4 questions and 5 questions. So option B is the correct answer here, poet asking the worshipper 3 questions. Then the next one question is, Tagore advises us, given options are worship God in our houses. Then he next option, sing in praise of God. Next option, wears holy dress. And the last one option is, work hard like a farmer. So the option D is the correct answer here, Tagore advises us, work hard like a farmer.
Then next one question is, God is pleased with our, given option are chantings and singing. Second option is doing socially useful and beneficial work. Then next option, telling beads and wearing mantras. Then the next option, worshipping every day. So option B is the correct answer here, doing socially useful and beneficial work. God is pleased with our doing socially useful and beneficial work. Then the next question is, according to the poet, chanting, singing and the tellings of beads, given options are meaningful, meaningless, sensible, worthy, worth doing. So option B is the correct answer here, meaningless. According to the poet, chanting, singing and telling of beads is the meaningless thing. Then the next one question is, the word tatters and the stain symbolizes, given options are tillings, the ground, hard work, cutting stone and the torn clothes. So option B is the correct answer here, hard work. The words tattered and the stain symbolize the hard work. Then the next one question is, deliverance is to be found, and given options are in the temple, in the chanting prayers, in the hard work, in the dusty soil. So deliverance is to be found in the dusty soil. So option D is the correct answer here. Then the next one question is, open thy eyes means, given options are wake up, see what is around him, come out of the ignorance and realize that morning. So open thine eyes means come out of the ignorance. So option C is the correct answer here. Then the poem Leave This Chanting and Singing by Rabindranath Tagore's MCQ. We will go into what the next poem, Felling of the Banyan Tree by the Dilip Chitre. So first question is, who write the poem Felling of the Banyan Tree? So given options are Dilip Chitre, Robert Burns, Rabindranath Tagore, William Wordsworth. So option A is the correct answer here, Dilip Chitre wrote the poem Felling of the Banyan Tree. Then the next question is, Dilip Chitre was, given options are teacher, painters, filmmaker, all the above. So option D is the correct answer here, all the above. Then the next question is, Dilip Chitre was winner of the given options are Nobel Prize, Dada Saheb Phalke Award, Sahitya Academy Award, Poet Laureate Award. So option C is the correct answer here, Dilip Chitre was winner of the Sahitya Academy Awards. Then the next question is, Dilip Chitre was bilingual writer but he's writing mostly in given options are Marathi, Hindi, English and Gujarati. So option A is the correct answer here, Marathi. What are the major themes of Dilip Chitre's poetry? And given options are exile, alienation, self disintegration, death, and all the above. So option D is the correct answer here, all the above. Then the next one question, Dilip Chitre's poem reflects, given options are cosmopolitan culture, then next one option urban lives and sensibility, oblique expression, and last one option is all the above. So last one option, option D is the correct answer here. Dilip Chitre poem dealings with the reflect with the cosmopolitan culture, also urban lives and sensibility and oblique expression. So option D is the correct answer here. Then the next one question, the poem Felling of the Banyan Tree is about, given options are cutting downs of the ancient banyan tree, then next one option is modern atmosphere, then next one option is mood to the Bombay, and the last one option is all the above. So option D is the correct answer here, last option is the correct here. Then the next one question is, where is the Dilip Chitre's live? So given options are Baroda, Bombay, Nagpur, Nasik. So option A is the correct answer here, Baroda. Dilip Chitre lives in the Baroda. Then the next one question is, where the banyan tree stood? Given options are in open yard, in open area, behind the poet's house, and the last one option is in the yard of the poet's ancestral house. So option D is the correct answer here, the banyan tree stood in the yard of the poet's ancestral house. Then the next one question is, who ordered tenants to leave? Given options are poets, poet's father, poet's grandfather, and poet's grandmother. So option B is the correct answer here, poet's father. Poet's father ordered the tenants to leave. Then the next question, who says to kill a tree is the crime to worship nature? Given options are poets, poet's father, poet's grandfather, and poet's grandmother. So option D is the correct one. Poet's grandmother says that to kill a tree is a crime to worship nature. Then the next question is, who could not live without nature? And the given options are college student, child, old generation, new generation. So option C is the correct answer here. Old generation could not live without nature. Then the next question, which tree was the most problematic to cut? And given options are Shevga, Neems, Audumbar, and Banyan. So option D is the correct answer here. The banyan tree was the most problematic to cut. Then the next question is, the banyan tree was how much tall as house? And given options are 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times. So option B is the correct answer here. The banyan tree was 3 times as tall as house. Then the next one question is, trees are scared, who said that? And given options are poets, poet's father, poet's grandfather, and poet's grandmother. And option D is the correct answer here. Poet's grandmother says that trees are scared. After the MCQs of the prose section and the poetry section, now we will going toward the grammar section's MCQ. So first section of the grammar article. So first question is, ... Ramayan is the holy books of the India. Choose the correct articles. And the given options are a and the, and the last one option is none. So option C is the correct option. The Ramayan is the holy book of the India. Then the next one question is, yesterday's I made ... European, find the suitable articles. And given options are a and the, none. And option A is the correct answer here. Yesterday I meet a European. Then the next one question is, I left it at office. And given options are a and the, none. And the option is, correct option is the, I left it at the office. Then the next question, he is a doctor. And given options are a and the, none. Option A is the correct answer here, a, he is a doctor. Then the next question, he drives at the speed of the 90 miles --hours, and given options are a and the none. An is the correct option here, means option B is the correct. He drives at a speed of 90 miles an hour. Then the next one question is, the river Yamuna --longest river of all, and given options are a and the none. So option C is the correct option here. The river Yamuna is the longest rivers of all. Then the next one question is, I went to buy --laptop computer next week. Given options are a and the. So option A is the correct answer here. I went to buy a laptop computer next week. Then the next question, can you please help me pick out --birthday present for my father, and given options are a and the. So option A is the correct answer here. Can you please help me pick out a birthday present for my father? Then the next questions is, --president of the United States will be the visiting Australia next week, and given options are a and the. So option C is the correct answer here. The president of the United States will be visiting Australia next week. Then the next questions, how much will it cost to go --holiday to ball, and given options are a and the. So option A is the correct answer here. A, how much will it cost to go on a holiday to Bali?
And we will going towards the next grammar part, preposition. And the first question is, Nafisa is afraid --spiders, and given options are from, in, about, of. So option D is the correct answer here, of. Nafisa is afraid of spider. Then the next one question is, I am worried --the exam, and given options are from, in, about, of. And option C is the correct one option here, about. I am worried about the exam. Then the next one question is, he looks upset. I think he took the criticism --hurt, and given options are to, in, about, of. And option A is the correct option here, too. He looks upset. I think he took the criticism to hurt. Then the next question is, I am envious --them. Given options are of, in, about, to. And option A is the correct option here, of. I am envious of them. Then the next one question is, he confided --me, and given options are of, in, about. And option B is the correct option here, in. He confided in me.
After that, we will going toward the next grammar section, verb. And first question is, --for a pen --these compositions, and given options are looks right, I am looking to write, looks for writing. So option B is the correct answer here. I am looking for a pen to write this composition. Then the next question is, she --up the stairs slowly because she didn't want, and given options are was climbing, fall, climbs to fail, fall, was the gamblings, fallings. And the option B is the correct option here, climbs to fall. She climbs up the stairs slowly because she didn't want to fall. Then the next one question is, the teacher --the student --the sum, and correct option is C, ask to solve. And the correct answer is, the teacher asked the student to solve the sum. Then the next one question is, nobody --that the innocent, and given options are is a believings, believers, believes, and believed. So option B is the correct answer here, believers. Nobody believers that is the innocent. And the Next one question is, although the children were tired, they playing. And the given options are, were counting. And the last one, continued. So, B option is the correct answer here. Although the children were tired, they playing continued. Now we will going toward the next grammatical parts, punctuation. And first question is, punctuation is a system of symbols that we use when dash dash a language. And given options are speaking, writing and hearing. So option B is the correct answer here, writing. The punctuation is system of the symbol that we use when writing a language. Then the next one question is, what are the symbols used in this system called as the punctuations? So first one option is punctuals, then next one option is punctuation, and the next one option is the punctuation marks. So option C is the correct answer here, punctuation marks. Then the next one question is, which are examples of the punctuation marks? And given options are commas and full stop, dollar and pound, then pulse and the plus and the minus signs. So option A is the correct answer here, commas and the full stop are the example of the punctuation marks. Then the next one question is, the full stop are also called as. Then given option is periods, endings and points. So option B is the correct answer here, ending. Then the next one question is, which cannot come at the end of the sentence? And given options are a period, a colons and the exclamation mark. So option B is the correct answer here, a colon. Cannot come at the end of the sentence. Then the next one question is, you must put a space dash dash every comma in a sentence. And given options are before, around, after and latter. So option C is the correct option here, after. You must put a space after every comma in a sentence. Then the next one question is, what is the punctuation marks indicating a question called? Then the options are the question tags, a question marks, a question sign. So option B is the correct answer here, a question mark. Then the next one question is, which can be used to express strong feelings in the written English? And given options are an exclamation marks, a question marks and a black leash. So option A is the correct answer here, an exclamation marks. Then the next one question is, quotation marks are put dash dash the words being quoted. And given options are before, after, before and after. So option C is the correct answer here, before and after. Quotation marks are put before and after the words being quoted. Then the next one question is, in a British English, in bracket are called as the round brackets, but in the American English they are often called as. And given options are round branches, then the square brackets, and the last one is parentheses. And the correct option is C, parentheses. After the MCQs of the prose section, poetry section and grammar section, we will going toward the last part of the syllabus, communication skill section. And the first one question is, communication is non-stop dash dash. And given options are paper, process, program, plan. And so option B is the correct answer here, communication is the non-stop process. Then the next one question is, the dash dash is the person who transmit the message. And given options are receiver, driver, sender, cleaner. And option C is the correct answer here, sender. The sender is the person who transmit the messages. Then the next one question is, communication is the part of dash dash skill. And given options are soft, hard, rough, short. So option A is the correct option here, soft. Communication is a part of the soft skill. Then the next one question is, dash dash is the person who notice and decodes and attaches some meanings to the message. And given options are receiver, driver, sender, cleaner. And option A is the correct option here, receiver. Receiver is the person who notices and decodes and attaches some meanings to the message. Then the next one question is, the response to sender message is called as. Given options are food bank, feedback, food back. So option B is the correct option here, feedback. The response to the sender's message is called as a feedback. Then the next one question is dash dash. Context refer to the relationship between the sender and the receiver. And given options are social, physical, cultural and chronological. So option A is the correct option here. Social context refer to the relationship between the senders and the receivers. Then the next one question, communication strengthens dash dash and dash dash relationship is a organization. And given options are employer father, employer employer, mother employer, mother child. So option B is the correct option here, employer and employer. Communication strengthen employers and employers relationship in the organization. Then the next one question is dash dash is the communication include the tone of voice, body language, facial expression and etc. So given options are non-verbal, verbal, letter, notice. So option A is the correct option here. Non-verbal communication include tone of voice, body language, facial expression, etc. Then the next one question is, letter, email, telephone are example of dash dash. And given options are message, feedback, channel, encoding. So option C is the correct answer here, channel. Letter, email, telephone are the examples of the channels. Then the next question is the oral communication, there is a possibility of the immediate dash dash. So given options are reaction, response, reflections and reset. So option B is the correct answer here, response. In oral communication, there is a possibility of immediate response. In this way, we will finish our MCQs of compulsory English FYBS semester first. And please remember that it's only a practice MCQ. This is very beneficial for your exam when you are facing the exam. If you like my video, please like it, share it, and do not forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and also press the bell icon for upcoming video or new updates. And also share this video to your friends, colleagues, to your teachers and so many online platform also. Thank you so much and all the best for your exam from Professor Rohit Salve. Thank you.